The first and the foremost thing that one must always understand to avoid being angry is that anger always comes from within and not from outside. In this video, I'll be talking about some various practical tips on how to avoid anger. So make sure you watch this video till the end and do subscribe to my channel for more updates. So before jumping on to how we can avoid being angry, let's first understand what anger really is. Anger is basically a reaction that we give to something which we often consider incorrect or unroyal. And in the process of it, our brain releases the cortisol and the adrenaline hormone, and which makes the matter even worse because it makes you react to that particular moment. Now, let me ask you one thing. How do you feel when you express your anger? I'm sure at that particular moment, you would feel a lot much relieved. But eventually, when you start thinking about it, you would finally realize that you've hurt the other person and you've hurt yourself as well. Because when you start to go back the memory lane, you realize that you shouldn't have said that or you shouldn't have acted that way. And you end up feeling regret, you end up feeling sad about yourself. So anger not only hurts the other person, it hurts you as well. So it's very important to have a hold on our anger and then understand where does it come from and how we can take good care of it. So here are some very quick tips on how to avoid anger at that particular moment. The first tip is that don't vent out your anger. I understand that people might have a different line of thought as you do. But expressing your anger wouldn't make that difference go away either. So instead of venting out your anger, try to think about the differences between you and that person and think about why do you think in a particular way and why do they think in a particular way. That way you would be able to save the relationship, that way you would be able to work on the relationship, and then you would give yourself enough time to talk about the differences and work on it. The second tip is very simple and it can be used any time and every time. It's as simple as that. Just breathe. Whenever you are feeling angry, you just have to do this thing. Breathe in, breathe out. Breathe in, breathe out. And you have to focus on that. You have to think, you have to imagine yourself breathing in the air coming into your lungs and then air going out of your lungs. That way, you would be able to shift your focus from anger to the breathing part. And in that particular moment, you would feel that you would give yourself some time to respond to that moment and not react to that moment. The third tip is change the vocabulary. So the next time you feel angry, instead of saying, I'm feeling angry, say this to yourself, I'm beginning to feel anger. So when you say that I'm beginning to feel anger, you give yourself some time to respond to that moment. Now, the fourth tip is get inside their head. Now, this might sound really funny, but it is actually a very important tip as well. So all you need to do is to get inside your head and try to think about that particular situation or that particular moment which irritates you or which makes you angry from their perspective. So instead of thinking about yourself at that particular point, try to think about why did they act in a particular way? Why do they think in a particular way? And when you try to think or when you try to observe things from their perspective, you'd finally realize that they too are right in their own way. When you get inside their head, you'd finally realize that everyone is subjected to their own opinions. Everyone is subjected to their own thoughts and you cannot change that either. So it's better to just let everyone be as they are and that would really help in combating the differences and that would really help you in controlling your anger as well.